Yes, y'all see, got more cowbell. Saturday Night Live. This, y'all wanted more of Saturday Night Live, so make sure y'all keep commenting down below. I think y'all wanted the Chippendales as well. Y'all just comment down the next video y'all want me to react to, because I definitely react to it. I do apologize that it is transparent. That's why I keep this right here. I try to keep this right here because it's black and you can kind of see it. If this chair wasn't there, it'd be like 10 times harder to see. So I try my best to, you know what I'm saying, show y'all as well. I do have people like, I wish you could see the whole thing, and I wish I can see on the screen. It's just when I edit and I show y'all it's transparent, that's just how it looks for y'all, you know what I'm saying, sadly. But I do get blocked from Saturday Night Live. But one thing that I do is try to, you know what I'm saying, get these videos out for my subscribers. So that's one thing that is, you know what I'm saying. I do apologize for that though, and it kind of, you know what I'm saying, it upsets me. But we all good because I'm getting it out. Make sure I hit that like button, hit that subscribe, and let's get a video.
After a series of staggering defeats, Blue Oyster Cult assembled in the recording studio in late 1976 for a session with famed producer Bruce Dickinson. And luckily for us, the cameras were rolling.
All right, guys, I think we're ready to lay this first track down. By the way, my name is Bruce Dickinson. Yes, the Bruce Dickinson. And I gotta tell you, fellas, you have got what appears to be a dynamite sound.
Coming from you, Bruce, that means a lot.
Yeah, I mean, you're Bruce Dickinson.
This is incredible. I can't believe Bruce Dickinson digs our sound.
Easy, guys. I put my pants on, just like the rest of you, one leg at a time. Except once my pants are on, I make gold records. All right, here we go.
Take a shot.
Don't fear the Reaper. Take one, roll it.
All right, one, two, three, four.
What are you saying? Bro, look how he's looking back though. It's all in his ear and shit. Bro, that's all you hear is that damn cowbell. That's literally all you hear.
In here for a second, please.
And you got it right next to his ear.
Guys, what's the deal?
Are you sure that was sounding okay?
I'll be honest, fellas, it was sounding great, but...
Bro, I know for a fact. Him singing like that, he probably can't even hear himself sing or hear the other. All he hears is that cowbell smacking his ear. That's all he hears.
That was going to be a great track. Guys, what's the deal?
Are you sure that was sounding okay?
I'll be honest, fellas, it was sounding great, but... I could have used a little more cowbell. So, let's take it again. And Gene.
Yeah.
Really explore the studio space this time.
You got it, Bruce.
I mean, really.
Yeah.
Explore the space.
Okay.
I like what I'm hearing. Roll it.
One, two, three, four.
Doing the ball. He's not even hitting it no more. Oh my God, bro.
Stop, Bruce. I'm
so irritated now.
Fellas, no. We just wasted two good tracks. This last one was even better than the first.
Well, it's just that I find Gene's cowbell playing distracted. I don't know. If I'm the only one, I'll shut up.
It's pretty rough.
You know, I can pull it back a little if you like.
Not too much, though. I'm telling you, fellas. You're gonna want that cowbell on the track.
You know what?
Listen, that cowbell do sound good. It sound good. Be hitting that mug a little bit too hard. Though.
I'm telling you, fellas, you're gonna want that cowbell from the track.
You know what? It's fine. Let's just do the thing.
Okay, roll it.
Roll it.
1, 2, 3, 4.
We gonna do it right on. He's getting on his nerves now, man. He gonna slow it down.
Come on,
damn.
Jimmy!
Damn.
That it doesn't work for me. I gotta have more cowbell.
Don't blow this for us, Gene!
Could be so selfish, Gene.
Can I just say one thing?
Yeah, baby, just say it.
Staring at rock legend Bruce Dickinson.
And a cock and a walk, baby.
And if Bruce Dickinson wants more cowbell, we should probably give him more cowbell.
Say, baby.
And Bobby, you are right. I am being selfish. But the last time I checked, we don't have a whole lot of songs that feature the cowbell.
I gotta have more cowbell, baby.
And I'd be doing myself a disservice and every member of this band if I didn't perform the hell out of this.
I can see why they laughing, though. Like, it's so... I did the, what was that reaction? Damn, I can't think of it. I think it was Matt Foley. Van Down by the River. I think that's what it was. And they was literally trying not to laugh so hard, but I could not be nowhere near him, like, doing anything professional. I couldn't be by
where for a cowbell, baby.
I couldn't be bombed.
But I'd be doing myself a disservice and every member of this band if I didn't perform the hell out of this.
Guess what? I got a fever. And the only prescription is more cowbell.
Thank you, Bruce. I think if,
look at his shirt.
If I just leave and maybe I'll come back later and we can lay down the cowbell.
Come on, baby.
Gene, wait. Why don't you lay down that cowbell right now? With us. Together.
They can't keep it together. He owned it in.
Do you mean that, Eric?
He speaks for all of us.
Thank you.
Babies, before we're done here, y'all be wearing gold-plated diapers.
What does that mean?
Never question Bruce Dickinson. Roll it.
Oh, shit.
1, 2, 3, 4.
That shit was funny. I ain't gonna cap. That definitely was funny. Y'all got me on that one. That one was lit. I ain't gonna cap. Make sure y'all comment down the next one down below. Make sure y'all stay tuned for more videos. Y'all already know what it is. Make sure y'all hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Catch y'all.